Why would you want to be nice to a narcissist and yellow rock them? Why would you want to be polite? Why in conversation, when a narcissistic person is coming at you with manipulation and criticism and critiques and all the horrible manipulative things that they do, the gaslighting, would you want to use yellow rock? Meaning be polite, be courteous, be kind. Let's talk about yellow rock. Let's talk about why you'd want to do it and how to do it. My name is Lise Colucci, and I am here to help you understand, transform your life after being around toxic, narcissistic people. Okay, so sometimes when you are parallel parenting or co-parenting with a narcissistic person, there's a need to have communication, right? Because you have to talk about the children. So oftentimes this is kept in written form. All of the information could be admissible if you are in the middle of a custody battle. So you're gonna wanna keep yourself in check. You're gonna wanna keep yourself polite, show that you are attempting fair and polite communication, show that you are not the source of the problem, all right? When we gray rock, we can sound really terse. We can sound like if you just took it out of context, you'd be like, oh, why is that person being so rude and toxic, okay? Because you have to be, right? When you gray rock, you cannot engage with the stuff coming at you. So the difference is you're doing this for the purpose of appearing to be someone that is trying to have pleasant communication with another party. Okay. That's one reason. Another reason is some narcissistic people handle gray rock as if it's a threat, as if it's something to come up against and to battle, right? So when you gray rock some narcissistic people by being boring, by not responding, by ignoring them, by just dismissal, right? It ups the game for them. So sometimes the yellow rock, so say you're in a work situation where you have a narcissistic boss. Can you imagine doing a gray rock technique with a narcissistic boss who needs attention? First thing they're gonna do is try and get more attention from you because you're not giving them any. Instead, if you said, "You're right. I saw that happen as well." And you walk away, right? It gives them what they need. In order for you to get away quicker, in order for you to not have to stand there and listen to them continually gaslight. So it's meant to diffuse a situation. It is not meant to placate because you want to give the narcissist some form of supply. Here's the truth. Narcissists aren't given supply. They take supply. They take supply by continual manipulation, by continual gaslighting, by forcing things into interacting, right? So they just take it. It doesn't matter what you do, they will still take the supply. You can ignore them and they will see that as a form of supply because look at you ignoring them. That must mean they're so important that they're deserving ignoring. And oh my gosh, how could you do that, right? So they keep it going. It's their drama, you guys. Who cares what they get? Let's just stop having it come from us as much as we possibly can, okay? And so sometimes yellow rock approach can help you with that because it sort of soothes the ego of the narcissistic person. So they think they're getting what they want. Who cares, right? And then you can get away. You can walk away, you can ignore it. This is not becoming a doormat, okay? This is not actually feeling the things you're saying. This is literally words meant to diffuse. And you don't have to go too far into it. You don't have to say too many words. In fact, the principles of gray rock still apply. Minimal, basic, boring. All you're doing is adding niceties on top of that that are tailor fit for that narcissistic person and the types of things that help them to calm down. You are managing down the situation instead of flatly ignoring the situation. Some narcissists react to that. So sometimes it's better to do this. Here are some things that are really important when you are using either yellow rock or gray rock. Okay, you've got to trust your side of the story being accurate for yourself, okay? If you start listening to the gaslighting, if you feel a need to defend yourself to the narcissistic twist of reality, right? When they are speaking from their narrative and they are changing the goalposts or they are changing the way things actually happen when they're talking to you. If you feel the need to defend yourself, if you feel the need to defend the situation, if you feel the need to be right, if you feel anything pulling from the inside of you that's going to make you feel like you need to be reactive to that narcissist, that's something to shore up, okay? You can't engage in something that is not real by trying to prove reality. Narcissistic people live in the delusion of the reality they're presenting you. Their narcissistic delusional reality. That is the only reality they want to believe. Okay, they don't want to see your point of view. This is not a two-way street. This is not two people relating to one another. This is the narcissist world and everybody else revolving around it. You have to remember that. And also that it is not important that that narcissistic person understand you, believe what you say. You know what I mean? Like, it really isn't important. And why isn't it important? Because everything that they do say they're going to believe, anyway, they're going to use against you later on. They're going to twist your words. They're going to twist the reality. They need things to follow their egotistical mindset. Look, your point of view matters, okay? Your point of view is yours. Your point of view is real to you. And your point of view is equally important to everybody else's point of view, but not to the narcissistic person. To people who are kind, to people who have empathy, to people who want to actually be your friend, to people who want to listen to you, yes, it's important, okay? But to a narcissist, they don't care. Another thing that's important for you to work on, if you are using gray rock or yellow rock for whatever reason in your life toward a narcissistic person, is to remember that you have boundaries and to be able to hold your boundaries, to be able to feel okay having boundaries with other people. If this is something you struggle with, you guys, check out the information in the main description for coaching, group coaching, or peer support, because it's important that you work on these boundaries and you get a firm foundation for yourself so that you are not pushed around by toxic people. And more importantly, you're not feeling guilty for setting boundaries with toxic people or anyone. So another thing that's really important if you're using gray rock or yellow rock is that your ability to process what has happened afterward, your ability to walk away from the situation and process the emotions that the manipulation, the gaslighting, and the hurt, the abuse has caused, okay? If you are not able to do that, that's another thing to really look to talking to someone about or finding support for, because processing it versus holding it in can make a huge difference. If you are gray rocking or yellow rocking a situation and you're holding back and you're feeling silenced and you're feeling shut down and you're feeling like you're the one who has to, right? Okay, you're the one who has to hold everything back and not speak their mind and, you know, you're feeling awful about it, then processing is kind of important for you. The thing is, arguing is not going to get you heard. You know, it has never worked, right? And being right isn't going to be right because the narcissist already has decided what right is. So it's important for you to have some tools in your tool bag for processing this stuff so that you aren't holding on to a lot of the stress from it. When you're doing this, one important thing to remember is know that you're playing a role, okay? You're not being you in this situation. You're not speaking from true authentic self, because the narcissist that you're dealing with does not care about your true authentic self. In fact, if you hand them your true authentic self, they are going to manipulate, they're going to use it against you, they're going to weaponize it. So when you're yellow rocking, you're not like actually feeling, oh my gosh, I hear you. You're kind of just saying, yeah, I hear your point of view. All right. You know, you're just saying words that fit the situation that are appropriate. That's it. And it's also really important to know what you're dealing with, know what to expect. I have said over and over and over here, the narcissist doesn't care about your point of view. The narcissist is operating from their own delusional self, right? Their own delusional mindset, their point of view. And that is it. They want the world to revolve around them. And that is all they're going to do. So know this, know the techniques that that narcissist uses. Know the way that they play at manipulating things. You know the person you've been dealing with pretty well is my guess. Okay, so don't expect it to be different. Don't expect yellow rock to make them someone else. That is not the point. The point is to diffuse it as quick as you can and get away from the situation. Or if you're dealing with them in a co-parenting way, to get only the information needed back and forth to serve the needs of the children. Don't engage. They may need to have the last word. Sure, let them. They're narcissists. Who cares? But know that you didn't engage in that. Take a deep breath. Look at who you're dealing with. Tell yourself, I do not engage in that nonsense. That's their nonsense. And step away from it. All right, let me know what you guys think. Have you dealt with this? Have you tried using yellow rock, and how has it worked for you?